there it's giving us stats. It says we've been streaming for 2 minutes.
Okay, that's very weird.
I'm gonna check the other.
Oh, are we on the...
No, it's just... Oh, damn. Maybe it changed. Did it change our streaming thing? That would be weird. I think there'd be an error. Oh, no, we're up.
Okay.
Okay,
cool.
Excellent. Let me turn that off and hide that so we're not streaming.
Cool.
Hello, peoples.
Hello.
Just a bit of technical stuff. We've got an extra complicated setup this time because we're doing 3 games and one of them is on the Dreamcast.
And 2 of them are on a barely emulated piece of obscure hardware.
So there's definitely going to be some slight pauses in between the games. Did you just tweet that out?
Yep, I just tweeted it.
Okay, let me retweet it. So we're going to be starting with Seaman on the Dreamcast with the little microphone and stuff. And I was testing it out today, so I think I know how to not kill our Seaman immediately.
If we do kill our Seaman immediately, it probably had it coming.
And it was probably my fault. Okay, retweet. Okay. So we're going to be cheating a bit on this one. Hopefully we've got the volume stuff working, because we really do need to be able to hear on this one. Or we don't. Okay. That's not good. Okay, 1 second, folks. We just gotta get volume working because we can't talk to the Seaman if we can't actually hear them. So that's plugged in okay. People amused.
How about I just stammer a lot? Is that okay?
Yeah, I guess so. That's plugged in. Let me check the TV options.
Like, we were getting audio output, it was just very quiet.
Oh, could you hear it at all?
Yes.
Okay.
I could hear it, it was just extremely quiet.
I think that was just coming from the TV.
Nope, that was coming from the headphone.
I'm getting nothing.
Oh, I'm getting nothing.
Yeah, no, it was the TV. Sorry, folks, 1 second. Like I said, this is an extra complicated setup, so of course things are going wrong. Okay. Menu.
Really, it would just not be one of our streams if we didn't have some terrible audio issue.
TV speaker. Try TV speaker off. Oh, no. Cancel.
Don't use that percent. Yeah, now try turning the volume up.
It doesn't even
do
anything.
We're not wacky Americans, we're wacky Canadians. Please, get it right.
Anything.
I am.
Oh, there we go. It's on.
Yeah, it's just,
okay.
It's just hard.
So be prepared for Leonard Nimoy. Tell us if the volumes are okay as well. Oh, let me switch to big screen.
Smaller or are we big?
We should be big now. Oh, we're small. The video's big.
Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay. So I'm making a new habitat.
Are you ready to enjoy your time with Seaman?
very much ready.
Today, January 1st of 2000. It's apparently also very quiet on the...
Is it really quiet on the stream?
Yeah.
Gasset's laboratory. Where is this laboratory? What awaits you within? You have no idea what Seaman is or how it evolved.
The volume, is it better?
This is something you must find out for yourself, as there is little documentation to help you on your way. My name is Leonard Nimoy, and I will be your guide.
Sounds good.
Well, super quiet.
This
for
is
us,
your first day with the Seaman. Your first step will involve preparing the tank for Seaman.
No, that
life.
Was the problem.
Adjust the tank settings to be an adequate temperature with sufficient oxygen. While adjusting, keep in mind that blue is the color of the sea, and thus an appropriate color for the care of Seaman. Then take the egg from the storage matrix and place it in the tank. The water's temperature is key to the hatching of the egg.
Sometimes that makes a
Once
difference.
Once hatched, the nautilus will play a very important role in Seaman's development. Each time you visit this laboratory, I'll be here to offer advice and guidance. If you tire of my voice, you may press the start button to skip at any time. Very well. Let us proceed to the tank.
That was a very long monologue.
Yep. Be prepared for more. Actually in right now, I believe. Yeah. You have to start by turning the light on. And we need to get the heat up to around 19.9 degrees. If we go higher than that, we actually have to wait for it to get colder. There's no way to make it colder. Which happened to me when I was doing a test run earlier today. Deceleration on the heat.
So is this like tutorialized? Is this in the manual? Or?
I think it's in the manual. I couldn't find my copy of the manual. So I just sort of looked online to see what the deal was. He does mention that like things are best if they're in the blue. So you kind of just move things until they go, the numbers go blue.
It's a very bold decision to start a game with making the heater very, very, very slowly, adjusting a thermostat.
I think that's kind of like the nature of this game is full of just weird decisions. It is definitely like the strangest virtual pet game.
Yeah, no, like usually they start with, you know, like an egg hatches.
Oh, an egg will hatch.
Okay, great.
Okay, so we're at least in the blue there. I'm gonna start getting some air in there. Very slowly see the fog. Different levels of lighting.
Oh, so it's not just that make the screen black then?
No. And they seem to pay attention to the lighting.
once we have some. Once I've got the air up, I'll explore the tank a bit, show some of the basic ways we can interact with the world. And then we'll get to attempting the hatch. We should probably fill an engine first. It takes everything like that, even if you're doing like sort of speedrun Seaman, everything takes a while.
Is there a Seaman speedrun? Like, does this appear at a Awesome Games Done Quick?
I don't know what that would look like.
What are the pro strats here?
Okay, so over here I've got my inventory. There's food pellets, and there is a Seaman egg. So it's like grab and then, oh, no. So it uses a pinch thing, sort of like a lot of Wii games do, where you're using the trigger and a button to pinch to pick things up.
That's cool.
And then let them go. So the egg has fallen in. Meanwhile, we will look at some of this stuff. There's this sort of weird nautilus creature. It's not quite a nautilus. You'll see later that it has kind of two nautilus shells side by side. There are some rocks. You can actually grab the rocks and move them around. If you move it over the air, you can actually kill off your seaman by mistake.
Or presumably by design.
Yeah, no, if you just hate them, which is...
Some in the chat say that they did do a speed run of The Town with No Name, which is the, which we'll show later, but is the Satellaview menu. How does that work exactly? Please.
Yeah, what is the wind condition that you're speed running towards?
Yeah.
So I think at this point it's sort of like, watch the egg, I can tap on the glass. Can't lift up the Nautilus yet. I don't think.
Is that a power you need to unlock?
We just need to get far enough along in the game.
To unlock the Nautilus?
Yeah. Let me just check. Okay, we can see the egg is doing some eggy things inside there. I'll work on getting the heat up a bit more. See if we can get at that perfect Seaman temperature.
Does the rock serve any purpose other than to accidentally kill the Seaman?
Well, it serves aesthetic purposes.
And what aesthetic purpose would that be exactly?
Is there a stone on the left or the right?
Does the feng shui affect the Seaman's growth at all?
Not to my knowledge.
Real missed opportunity.
Yeah, I think it was. Okay, I actually need to make sure I don't go over, because I'm going to wait for it to cool back down in real time. So, we can actually get them all the way to hatching in one go, but what I am going to do is actually interrupt every once in a while for us to reset, because we can hear new things that Leonard Nimoy says about the state of the game.
Alright, that's important.
But the first thing we need to do is see this egg actually hatch. Will it hatch faster in the dark?
Does the egg glow in the dark?
No. No, it does not.
Okay. This is some thrilling stuff.
Yeah, no. When I said it acts in real time, it really does. Yeah, we'll re-grab this. We'll become more things to interact with as we get farther in. But this beginning is very much just like throw an egg in. Oh!
Whoa.
I think it's starting to separate.
That's really upsetting.
Oh, if you find that upsetting. This definitely, out of all virtual pet games, is the most, like, nightmare fuel. That Nautilus is not going to come out of this well.
Oh dear.
The pitch black darkness outside. Oh! It just burst.
Okay.
So we have the first form, the mushroom arms. And if I tap on the glass, they kind of pay attention to that. And I can even, let me zoom in on one. If you look carefully, they actually have kind of little, yeah, they're eyeballs.
Okay, that's...
And if we want to, we can grab them and look at them.
I really don't like this hand.
There's a lot of things not to like about this game. The hand is only one. Oh, there we go. It's wriggling. So let's restart the Dreamcast and see what Leonard Nimoy has to say. It's fingernails. No, I don't at this point.
Okay.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gassin. This is your second visit today. It is good to have you back so soon. Let's see. The eggs in the tank have hatched, and 8 larvae were born. They are called mushroomers. Have you seen them drifting around? The mushroomers are timid at first, but will soon respond to your tapping by floating toward the sound. At the moment, the habitat
the
contains
on the side is breathing.
8
yep.
mushroomers. They are enjoying a comfortable environment. I'm sure they will respond to your feelings for them. Allow me to divulge today's highlights. The mushroomers have a lifespan of only 4 to 5 days. In that time, you must discover how to help them reach the next step of their evolution. You can take advantage of their instinctive attraction to sound by tapping on the glass. The nautilus at the bottom of the tank may play a key role. So let us head over to the tank.
Does Leonard Nimoy only appear in these introduction bits?
I believe so. He basically like introduces you each day. And if you keep coming back, he'll comment on the fact that you've like visited so many times.
That's really weird.
Like they actually put a lot of attention into his interaction, since the game is so much about coming in day after day. So let's have a look at the mushroomers. Oh, weird, is it breathing? I think it is. It just attached its tube to the surface. Weird.
Oh, not sure they're doing it. So what was he saying about the Nautilus?
Let's have a look at it. Pick it up yet? Gotta get some of the mushroomers near it.
Someone's asking, does the clock matter in this?
Yes, it does. The entire thing is running in real time. If you leave it for a while, the tank will slowly get darker, or get colder. So we need to make sure that if we're going to leave it for a day, that we set all the settings well. Looks like the Nautilus is on the move.
Is it? Oh, God.
There, we can have a look at it now. So yeah, as you can see, it's not actually a regular Nautilus. It's got, like, 2 different valves.
Oh, weird.
It'll come out enough for us to see the eyes. Wish I could shake it. It's would have been a great Wii game. Like, if I could, like, shake it around and stuff. I think that was a bit of a missed opportunity, not putting this on the Wii. Okay, drop it back in. Zoom in on it. Oh! Ooh. Not sure if it liked that mushroom off. Another one? Weird creepy eyes spiraling past. Yep.
Oh dear.
Yeah, not sure if that's a healthy response. About the newest. Oh, it ate another one.
So you're pulling them near to the
glass. Yeah, and basically tapping on the glass makes it move towards what you tapped on. They're attracted to the noise.
Well, this is upsetting.
Oh, it ate another.
I feel like that's really a lot of ink.
Yeah. Okay, let's just check. Oops. We don't need this right now. Just make sure that our air was in a good situation. Look how those top ones look like weird eye stalks.
Yeah.
Heat it up a bit.
Does the air heat go down over time?
Yeah, it goes down in real time, even if the machine's toned off.
So, if you come back in 2 days, it'll be like...
Yeah, if you leave them alone for too long, it'll be freezing and eventually they'll die.
It's not how aquariums work.
It's how this aquarium works. They put the aquarium on hard mode. Okay, I think this is good.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Yes, anymore, I would. What are folks saying on chat?
They're upset.
That is the
cool. Which is extremely reasonable.
Okay, I think I'm gonna go forward a day now. I think that's safe to do.
So for this particular game, we're going to be cheating the real-time aspect a little bit, just because otherwise it would not be very interesting.
Yeah, especially for this beginning bit. And what we're kind of thinking is we've got a few games now that are sort of serialized, and we'll basically come back to these games for the next few weeks. And see how each of them are doing.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory, Jean-Paul Gasset. This is your third visit today. Although your care is appreciated, it is not necessary for you to lavish quite so much attention on Seaman. Very well. Have you noticed that the Nautilus has begun to eat the mushroomers? I wonder what's in store next. At the moment, the habitat contains two mushroomers. They are enjoying a comfortable environment. Let me divulge the highlights for today. Watch carefully to find out what happens to the Nautilus now that it has eaten some of the mushroomers. So let us head over to the tank.
So we're going to actually reset properly. Make sure that this tray is totally open.
Wait, you had it open and it counted as... That's a...
Okay, so... Just go forward a day. Close it up. He did narration for the weird Bjork app.
Really?
There's actually a whole documentary about her and David Attenborough that I really want to track down.
That sounds incredible.
Yeah, it sounds like the best thing ever, basically.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. Let's see. Last time, have you noticed that the Nautilus had begun to eat the mushrooms?
Okay, we've all heard this. I'm going to interrupt.
I wonder what...
Wait for him to cough. Oh, he doesn't cough this time. So I guess I've got multiple things that he'll say if you interrupt him by hitting start. When I was testing earlier today, he coughed when I did that. Just check. Yep, so the arrow's gone down. Let's get everything.
Oh, yeah, that'd be like dead.
Yeah, so we need to make sure that before we switch days, we always set things up. I think we'll be able to do everything that we want to do for this week. Get to the point where we can at least do a little bit of microphone stuff. Mushrooms?
I think it ate them all.
No, there's still at least two.
Oh.
Eat mushrooms in the dark. Whoa. Okay, that was weird. Ooh, that's not good. He's doing some shiveries. That's healthy in a Nautilus, right?
Sounds like we probably have to turn down the volume slightly.
Is that good, folks?
It sounded like the air was just too loud.
Ah, okay. Ooh, heater. Heater's not a good place.
Do we need to make a higher temperature?
Yeah, no.
I can't tell if this is supposed to represent it moving erratically or if it's just having a real hard time with collision detection.
It doesn't matter where it is. That's it. Like, just, yeah, having a bad day. Let me grab it. This looks pretty
much...
It
sounds like the mic's too quiet.
Oh, the mic's too quiet. Okay. The mic is as high as we can put it.
Okay.
So we'll have to speak up a bit, or I'll move the mic a little bit closer to us.
Okay. Hopefully that'll be better.
Let us know if that's a bit better. We'll try to speak up. Come on, eat the mushroomers. You love mushroomers. They're delicious.
I don't know if it loves them. It seems that it's distinctly not.
They're delicious little eyeball critters. Eat them.
Apparently better.
Okay. I think if we kept on skipping days, we might miss the next step.
Does it, like, do something to force it so that, you always see what happens?
I don't know. I can't remember whether that's the case or not.
Well, like, I noticed that it didn't eat them off screen.
Yeah. But they also may not have floated close to it. Whereas this is definitely something that has, like, a time limit. But I think we do need to be watching to actually see it happen. I think they avoid realism in favor of making sure you see every gruesome detail of the Seaman life cycle. I like that this game basically, like, it takes, while it is not realistic, it takes a lot of the weird shit that actually happens with creatures in nature and the strange, like, parasitic.
It's a good simulation of how weird.
Yeah, how weird, gross, and disturbing nature actually is some of the time. Come on.
Trust you anymore.
I'm the most annoying neighbor. Eat us. Eat us. Don't know what is up with that spiraling behavior they do.
Oh god, they approach sound because they want to be eaten, right?
They might, I don't know.
I mean, like, that would...
Yeah, that kind of makes sense. Oh, oh! It's come out of its shell. And it's coughing blood.
It's not doing well.
And yeah, at this point I can't grab it because it's in the middle of a situation.
No, it's definitely blood. The
yeah,
ink
no,
is black.
The ink is black.
There's also
is...
some ink in there, but it's
yeah.
mostly blood.
This is like a mating ritual or something, right? Like, it's just dancing. I'm sure it's fine. It'll just crawl back into its shell. Totally healthy. Good times.
Yeah, no, like, I want the nature documentary narration over this.
Yeah, no, they separate the two.
Just like Leonard Nimoy calmly describing these death throes.
Well, we can find out now. I could save and see if he has something to say specifically about the state it's in right now.
Mm.
But we should do it quickly if we're going to do that. Because I don't think it's going to last much longer.
Sure. Oh, something's happening. Listen, the game is called Seaman, not Nautilus. It's don't even worry about this creature.
Our heroes were the mushroomers. And this jerk ate them. Just getting what he deserves.
I mean, they wanted to be eaten.
Man, this is a long death, though.
Yeah.
The squid is just, like, hamming it up. Oh, the pain, the pain. I'm trying to get the mushroomers to come visit it.
We apparently have 70 people watching this. This almost died.
Yeah, so just playing to the crowd. Oh. Man, both is such a beautiful thing.
That's...
So here we have the next form.
Right. Awesome.
Let's have a better look at it, though.
Let's not.
Listen to his childish giggles.
Sorry, I was laughing at the chat, not at this horror show.
What is the chat saying?
extremely reasonable things.
Yep. So at this point, while they can't speak, they will utter baby talk. So here, I'll turn off the lights. Let's just get some air.
Okay, so now we can just remove them all, right?
That's not our job, Christine.
Really? Because we sure did it to the Nautilus.
Just let nature take its course.
Yeah, what?
So yeah, they'll say sort of nonsense things. React to what you're doing, but now I can actually use the mic. So this is very, very primitive speech recognition, so I have to sort of like press, wait a second, talk, wait a second, release, and then if they're talking, I can't talk over them or it doesn't work. Luckily the VMU screen, the little screen on the controller, will tell me whether it heard anything and whether it understood it or not. It shows either three question marks, if it's like, what the hell did you say, or it'll show an exclamation mark, meaning that they saw Solid Snake and that it understood what I said.
So what does Leonard Nimoy have to say about the miracle of life?
We'll find out soon, but first I want to say something to them. Hi. Recognize it? Hi. God damn it. Maybe I need to, oh, there's the temperature. Okay, I've got one in screen. Hello. Doesn't seem to be recognizing it. Hello? Sega. I liked that when I said that to them before. Oh!
Yeah.
I'm hitting the wrong damn button. Hello? Hello?
Seafoy.
Sega.
More
That's one of the few words they understand at this point. Good fish. Good. Didn't understand that.
Bad fish. Bad fish.
Bad.
Meow, meow,
it understood meow. That, but it just said meow, meow, meow.
Good chat.
Okay. So we've talked to them. Do we want to just hear what Leonard Nimoy has to say, and then we'll...
Yeah, sure.
We'll call it a day for this and switch to the next game.
Sure.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Yes, I would. So polite. I'm terrified of you.
You're not missing any interesting conversation from the Seaman. They're just babbling.
Yeah, they're just saying baby talks. Are people having trouble hearing them?
No, it's just that because of the delay,
oh.
Your talking is coming over.
Oh, okay.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Garcin. This is your second visit today. It is good to have you back so soon. Very well. Did you see it? The Nautilus has become prey to the parasitic mushroomers, and thus the gill men were born. Gill stands for the gills of a fish, So a gillman is a being who breathes underwater. Gillman has learned human words. Try speaking to him, if you haven't already. At the moment, the habitat contains 2 mushroomers, 6 gillmen. They are enjoying a comfortable environment. Please continue your good work watching after them. So let us head over to the tank.
Yeah, we'd really like to stream Hey You Pikachu, but unfortunately, it's impossible to emulate because the N64 microphone, the way it did speech recognition was there is actually a chip inside the microphone that, like, recognized speech. So in order to do that, we would actually have to track down all the requisite hardware for it, which is not super hard, but enough.
Unlike this, where I actually owned everything.
Right.
I pretty much have a full set of weird Dreamcast peripherals. Okay. So I'm gonna let them sleep. Whoa, creepy.
Don't talk to us, Seaman.
Would you like to save and end the session?
That was, like, weirdly loud compared to everything else.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll come back to the Seaman next week to find out what horrible next form they will take.
Oh god.
Because nature is gross and terrible.
Okay, cool. We're just going to be taking a moment to switch.
Yeah.
Yes, that is definitely the Dreamcast disc drive in the background. It's extremely loud. It's as loud as it sounds.
Yeah, it is the loudest thing ever. So I'll switch us over to the big screen.
Can you use the Dreamcast fishing rod to catch Seaman?
Oh man, that is like one of the few peripherals I don't have, is the fishing rod.
Okay, so let's get this.
Yep. Power that off. Plug that.
Where's the app?
Plug that in. You need the splitter? Splitter's right here.
Okay.
I think I've got a long enough headphone cord. I don't know if you're okay.
I'm just going to move this, like, a little bit closer.
Yeah, we can move it a little bit closer.
And hopefully the computer doesn't overheat.
Yeah. So once you've got that on, we have to reset a few things to get the right...
Do you have that plugged in?
Yeah, it's plugged in. So,
okay, because I'm not seeing a signal.
It won't until you, like, get it up to full screen, and then I'll go through the process of getting it to show up.
Okay.
I have to tell it that we're no longer using the super shitty stuff and are using HDMI.
Okay, we're up.
Okay, configure video, and we are HDMI, we are not standard def, and deactivate, and activate, get Christine's laptop up here, and then I've got to move, why is it showing the Dreamcast?
That's a good question.
That's very strange. Oh, that's frozen from before.
Yeah.
Sorry, folks, we'll just be a second. Takes a little bit to get everything set up for a completely different input device.
Okay, so right now we're seeing black just because that's what's...
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
There we go.
Okay. Let me just see if this is... Looks like it's centered okay.
Cool.
I will switch us back over. Okay, we're back.
Cool.
Yeah, this is a little bit.
Yeah, so let us know how the audio sounds. Right now, this is probably too loud.
I turn that, if you turn it on its side, I should be able to actually get this far enough.
Oh.
It's a little bit too short.
I see.
I'm slowly compiling a list of cables I need
okay.
to buy.
Is that better?
For us to do this better. Yep, that's great. Okay.
Okay, how about the, how's the audio now?
Yeah,
turn
let's turn off the audio. People saying turn it down a bit?
Well, I changed it and... So don't do anything just yet.
So engulfing a luxurious cruiser ship.
Okay, sounds like we're good otherwise.
Okay. It's just loud for us. You could maybe turn the sound up one notch, but it's fine. Okay, I'll turn it up a teeny, teeny bit.
So this is SOS, which was made in mid-90s, 1994 apparently, which is, it's set on a ship that's, in the process of capsizing, and over the course of an hour, it will sink. So we have one real-time hour to
win the game with the character we've chosen.
Yes.
And to attempt to rescue as many people as possible.
You can only actually rescue 7 people, and they will follow you around, which is... We'll see how that goes.
Yeah. It's a game made to be replayed, but not a roguelike, and that it doesn't have procedural stuff.
Yeah, this is just a regular Super Nintendo game. It came out here. Let's start with,
Sure, we know nothing about them, so... Humbleton. Humbleton offing. I like the ship bobbing.
Yeah. I don't know how we're gonna feel about that, some interesting, dialogue breaking up.
Are you in control of this store cutscene?
Nope, this is just cutscene.
Cheer up! There's a storm coming!
Alright, good chat.
One of the other buttons maybe make her do it?
Cool, we just lost, what's happened? Did we go into a... Not sure what happened there.
Yeah. What the?
Yep, now we're upside down.
It looked like he was doing something incredibly rude to that corpse.
Hang out, please. Okay,
oh no,
so
communication.
These controls are, let's say, extremely bad. Wait, are we going the right way? No, we're going the wrong way.
Oh.
Right, because we're upside down now.
Ah.
That makes a lot of sense. Okay, so in order to do... You press Y when you are in front of the door, and you can open it. But, like, it's not automatic. You have to do it mid-jump.
Oh, weird.
Yeah, it's super weird.
Oh, it's that guy.
Oh, yeah. Let's... Oh, God. Are we gonna catch him?
Answer. Oof.
Haha, jokes.
Sergeant Rattler.
Okay, so starting at the moment it capsized, it's not showing this on screen, but there's a 1 hour timer.
Though your health is also done in time, so if we fall a bunch.
Yeah,
instead of
like losing. So this is, we can, we're just gonna have to carry this guy around with us for the rest of the game. And he'll sort of follow us, but apparently, it's not great about this, so... that'll be fun.
I guess we go the other way now?
I guess so. Well, I mean, we're definitely not going that way. Can I get up? No, I cannot get up there. Oh, she's...
Is the timer on screen for you? No. Like,
nope,
you're seeing what we're seeing. Okay, so if you do the summon, will he show up?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe? Actually.
Oh, yeah. Give him a second to see if he shows up.
Yeah. Okay, that's extremely weird. Okay, I don't like this guy anyway, so
whoa.
I'm not gonna... Well, right, we're having fun now. Oh, we just went through that door. Okay. Yeah, so this is, using Mode 7. The ship will rotate. Let's see if now that things have changed, we can actually, I'm really concerned that guy's not following us.
Yeah.
Oh, we just totally lost him. I think he's gone. Okay, cool. Great. We lost that guy. Fun time. Oh, okay, now we can...
I think you might have your computer set with a,
Yeah, I'm gonna check, make sure we're not hitting screensaver. I think that's what's happening right now. So just bear with us for a second.
Yeah, one sec. Somebody wants to check a FAQ for us and see.
I do have a FAQ on my iPad, so I can just hand that over to you.
What the deal is with NPCs.
Yeah, they're supposed to follow you around, and you have that summon button to get
them
to.
Like, do we just lose them if we go too far away from them?
Yeah, here, so you can.
Okay. I can FAQ look.
You can look at the FAQ. Let's. So yeah, now that this is rotated, we can get through this door.
SOS back.
I don't think we're in the right place, though.
Communicate, reply to answer, button. This button is basically... Okay, there's also an action button as well
yeah.
as the communicate button.
Right, I think that's a...
Whoa, what is...
Okay,
oh.
So she won't move unless we get her children.
Is that water?
That's water.
That effect is not working.
It's,
May have been fine on
okay,
a
so
CRT.
This is, yeah. Yeah, unfortunately we can't use blurring because our computer is not quite powerful enough for that. Let's go find her sister. So what's the action button? Is that just
it doesn't
why?
Say. I think you're going to have to just jam things until you figure it out. It's probably the one you're using to open
yeah,
doors.
Yeah, that's what I figure. So yeah, and it might not be noticeable now, but this at the angle is actually changing over time. So it's slowly rotating. It's not just like at fixed angles.
Jeez, there are a lot of characters.
Yeah. Oh, we just, we're straight again. And I'm really not sure where we are relative to where we're supposed to be. Yeah, it's very weird interacting with upside-down stairs.
Yeah, there isn't a ton of information about how they follow you in this.
Yes, the rotations are at fixed time, so it's always the same in every playthrough. Which means that effectively there are certain parts of the ship that you can only, like, navigate through at certain times.
I guess it's a variant, in a way, of the, like, Majora's Mask-style
yeah.
gameplay. Of
oh,
like,
we just landed in fire.
Ooh.
So that's going to take 5 minutes off our timer. Yeah, so we have 46 minutes left. And I'm not going to go through fire. That's bad. Let's not do that. Okay. This isn't great. Not really sure how to navigate. Oh. Yeah, no. The way you handle, like, pulling yourself up from staircases is really weird.
Yeah, no, I'm not super clear on where the points are.
It's not very intuitive at all.
Oh!
Fell from too high, so we lost another 5 minutes.
Can I give it a try?
Yeah.
Let's see how terrible these platforming controls are. Oh, somebody talking about Dead Rising.
Yeah.
Yeah, the comparison to Dead Rising is one I've seen for this game.
So, yeah. Eat a jump. Don't go into fire. Don't,
yeah.
Just stay away from that those flames. They're not a good
okay.
time.
Go. No, that's not a
no.
actual path. Do we know where we're trying to go right now?
Not... I mean, presumably we're trying to get to our sister, but we don't actually... Try pressing select. Okay, so that pulls up a map. Oh, and it shows where we are in the map.
But not where we want to go.
We can definitely, I'm gonna cheat and look at the fact and find out where our destination is, otherwise we're gonna have a problem.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I'm gonna get us lost.
Cool.
It's a plan. As soon as I can figure out how to navigate.
Good plan.
It's very Prince of Persia-y, only...
Except ugly.
Yeah, and Prince of Persia has very, like, defined edges for things. Whereas this definitely does not.
I'm really unclear as to, like, even what climbing up these stairs upside down represents. It's very ambiguous.
Oh, and it has to be pixel perfect. Like, I was...
I think there's a little bit of,
No, but I was, like, touching the edge, but I wasn't touching it enough.
Okay, so pull up the menu.
Give me a second, I'm just trying to...
Pull the map.
I'm trying to communication. Okay. Pulling up to the map.
Okay, so... We are trying to go here. And right now we are here.
We're trying to go down right now? Well, I guess those are those levels.
I think we're actually going up
it?
Right now because the ship's upside down.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. Oh god, the map doesn't turn, but the... Oh!
Yep. I like that. I really like that, actually.
That's... Yeah. No, that's both good and oh god. I wonder if I go through this door where that takes me. Can I go through this door?
Yeah, you can press the door button while jumping.
What is the door button?
It's Y.
Okay.
However, it's not... Yeah.
There we go.
It's a little bit difficult.
Yeah. Oh, we're here now, above that dude.
So I think you can...
Can we rescue?
Right.
No.
He has a dead child. I don't think he's coming. Or try, yeah. Why are you jumping?
I'm not upset at all.
So the UI on this is really weird, but part of the reason why,
okay,
like,
it's moving now, I think.
It's undecorated and just, like, a black box at the bottom is because of the way rendering on the Super Nintendo works. If you try to draw... Pull up the map again, see if we're,
okay.
if we're going in the right direction. Where's her icon?
Not visible. I mean, maybe we can't look at the...
Not here. Oh, okay. Try going into a door. Okay, now.
Huh.
Okay, that's... Oh, wait, no. There's a blinking.
Oh. The door is blinking.
Oh.
Okay, we are going the right way then. Let's
okay, yeah, we are, so let's...
Oh god, it's slowly... tilting around.
But yeah, as I was saying, the reason why is because, the way Mode 7 works is you can't, you couldn't have all these, like, the text layer over top, so it has to be at the bottom like that.
I was depressed and my friends left me behind. What about you? What are you doing here? Pickup artist.
Wait, that means he would absolutely know the ship really well. Buddy, I don't think he thought this through.
So we know our character's classist. So what is the tally-ho button?
I think it's
there, got it.
Yeah.
Either one of those works. Either trigger.
So you're gonna wanna, hit the door button while jumping. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, got him. Someone else in the chat was pointing out like how the chandeliers are still intact.
Yeah.
Just
upside down.
Just upside down. It's fine. Don't even worry about it.
With some upside down fire. Still not used to the Super Nintendo. I keep on thinking of the Xbox layout.
Oh yeah, no, it's very weird. Might have to holler to me. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Do we know where we want to go next?
Pull up the map.
Oops. Whoa. What just happened?
That's a great question. Yeah, eventually it starts to the ship starts to flood. We might be close to that given we lost 10 minutes.
Dude, it's not pulling up the map now.
Oh, it might not while...
while it's spinning. Okay, we're still around... Oh, I guess that shows we're in that doorway area. Let's find out where this goes.
Cool. Oh, no.
Come join me, it's beautiful here. I have no idea where I'm going.
How's the map looking?
Still shows us blinking in that doorway.
Oh, weird. That might...
I'll check again.
That might... not be our location?
Might be where we want to go?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Oh! I was trying to get the door.
Yeah,
but I hit
the jump controls in this are not great. So yeah, our stream of this game for the first one is definitely going to be less than an hour. Alright, want to try it again?
Yeah, so I can like do it in a...
I think you're going to have to...
Okay, so I want to hit Y while jumping.
Yes. Also, it might not work. Well, this might be very short.
I think I'm going to try going in a different direction.
Possibly a good idea.
Oh, I forgot to change the description to say that we're playing this and not Seaman.
Oh, well.
Oof.
You want me to take over while...
That is some bad collision detection.
Oh, no. That's not a great time.
Oof. Although, to be fair, like, making an engine that could deal with all this rotation is pretty impressive for the time.
Oh, yeah.
Let me get in there and switch.
All right, the angle changed, so it might be easier now. Or we might just die.
I think it's a bigger drop to your death. Plus or minus.
The actual... Yes! Got it!
Nice.
Oh no, can't follow. Well, we just lost.
Oh, so really hard jumps are too hard for them to follow.
That's really weird.
Wow, what a weird game.
Yeah. Yeah, no, this is definitely like a lot of interesting ideas and... I think a lot of this is just technology, like, it's very difficult to handle this sort of, collision detection.
I think it's that also, like, I think this is the type of game that the first time doing something that does this many new things, you're not gonna do most of them terribly well.
I think, I don't think that glowing god is us.
Yeah.
Oh, we can zoom in. This is...
Interesting. Can we rotate it? We can! Whoa! Oh, nice!
Okay, this is good.
That's really good. That's super, super good.
I love it, but also I don't actually...
Unfortunately, we have no idea where we are.
Absolutely no clue. Yeah, it's unfortunate they're not labeled at all, so like, there's no way you could get your orientation. I think we're probably close to... Okay, so let's... Are we upside down or are we... Yeah, we're upside down.
At a 45 degree angle.
Okay, so... We are... Like this? Or no, we're like this.
Yeah. We have no idea which of those identical looking rooms we're in.
Yeah.
I feel like this would have really benefited from, like, different decks having different color schemes.
Oh, that would be really helpful, yeah.
Like, there's a lot of, like, little things, but also things that would have cost money to do.
I think that would have been fairly easy to do. Like, if they literally just, like, made the walls painted different colors, like...
Just do, like, palette swaps.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, I feel like going with the Prince of Persia thing, like, Prince of Persia, in general, I'm not a fan of that style of platforming where you have no control over your movement after you start jumping. Although it looks like maybe you've got a teeny bit of air steer. I think it's an especially bad choice when you've got this rotation.
Yeah, I feel like you definitely need...
Prince of Persia, like the original Prince of Persia, is set up so that you can basically see the grid
in
its layout.
In this,
so you know exactly how far you can jump. Exactly. Oh fuck!
It's okay. We're not going that way. That's not a thing anymore. Cool. Oh okay, but. That would have been extremely bad if... Also, it doesn't even matter. It doesn't even matter. There wasn't anything we could actually do. Cool. Great. Alright, fun times. Yep, that's... Alright, let's go back down.
Oof!
Okay. Yeah, I think the next time we start, we're going to pay much closer attention to the map.
Yeah. And maybe see if we can find a good, like, video tutorial to get us a little bit better. But
he's still here!
Hey.
Buddy.
I thought you were doomed.
Yeah, me too, actually.
truth is, we got like 15 minutes, so...
So we absolutely are doomed. Like, no question.
I think it was the right decision, though, for us to go into this blind the first
time.
Oh,
absolutely, I think. Yeah, we tried looking for the manual, but no one has scanned it.
It's a popular game.
Get it together, buddy. Oh, shit. I'm the one who needs to get it together.
That was an interesting move you just pulled off. Can you make it if we... Oh. I think we might be in the next... Oh.
Your screen went black again.
Okay, what's our orientation now? Oh, I do like how you can tell by the staircases. So that helps. We're now like this, I think? No, we're not like that at all. We're...
Weird like that, like it's on its end.
Like this?
Incidentally, I really like the moment when you were standing on a platform, things tilted, and you just sort of grabbed the platform edge. That was one smooth moment in the mechanics so far.
Oh, now we have an icon again. I'm really not sure what, determines...
Okay. I wonder if the emulation was causing a bug where, like, if we're in some one of those.
So, this is extremely accurate hardware emulation, which is extremely difficult and requires a lot of processing power, but we need it for the Satellaview emulation. Ordinarily, like, emulators do a lot of shortcuts that, cause weird bugs, especially in games that no one's ever played. But in this case, we should be pretty accurate.
I wonder if there's a button we push that turned off our...
Oh, I wonder. I've hit everything.
Mm. And we know we're somewhere in that area because we were in that area just a second ago.
Yeah. What happens if we're near a door?
It looks more like a prison ship than a cruise ship. Yeah, it's like a guilt prison ship. Like, lots of little fancy things, but yeah.
Okay, cool. We're in the toilet now. Not really sure where we are now. This is...
I think we must be getting into, like, the engine room type areas.
So the engine room is where the game ends, is you have to get to the... Great. Cool.
It's a game that would definitely benefit from being able to put a marker down for.
That would be.
Like, there's so much going on here that I think some of those like handle-y things from modern games.
I think are really necessary.
Yeah.
Frankly.
Oh Jesus! So each of those doors.
I think so. Oh, so we can use the bathrooms to navigate. I'm not entirely sure how, but...
Yeah, I wish this map was a bit, like, had some labeling.
Yeah, but I do like that, like, there's an area with a lot of really complicated geometry, so... You can, like, navigate it no matter what your orientation is.
It's funny, the maps in this are sort of, in a way, the opposite of the maps in the original Thief, with it basically being that you'd be getting, like, hand-drawn things where somebody had some of the information, but not all of it. So it'd have, like, important landmarks located and... Indicating like where the important stuff generally was, but you wouldn't actually see the exact geometry. And this, you sort of have the exact geometry, but no sense of what is actually in a location.
Yeah. Oh, and the chat is complaining about the music being just one loop, which is definitely I maybe would have gone another way.
Yeah, I'm guessing they don't have an option to turn the music off.
No.
Not much stuff from this time had that.
No.
So Atari Lynx actually had
a
dedicated shortcut that worked on all games to turn off music but not sound effects.
Huh, that's cool.
Wait,
which made sense for a handheld, especially, where you might be playing it for ages.
Yeah.
Music stop. I've actually taken my headphones off so I don't have to hear it. Yeah, still going.
Okay, I really hope this doesn't kill me.
Oh.
Oh, oh god.
Oh.
That could have been extremely bad.
Now, realizing what you'd have to know to be really good at this game. Like,
I imagine, so it looks like there is some unique stuff, like, for example, there's a section with no power, which is, like, very distinctive.
But no, just knowing, like, that, like, okay, I need to be at this spot at this time,
yeah.
It's going to be at this angle.
You know, I bet the manual came with a map that you can mark up. Like,
yeah,
you know,
it could be.
And if it didn't, it really should have. And definitely,
Oh, fuck! Did you just drown?
No.
Okay.
Oh, God. Oh! Yeah, I'm always terrified of all these jumps. So, yeah, the ship is starting to take on water, and it will take on more as we go. So, we're gonna drown. Oh, God.
Oh, no! Oh,
yep.
No!
Let's get out. Yeah, okay, let's get out of this part of the ship before it completely floods.
Oh, this is great, I've gotta say.
Oh man. And this also opens up areas because, you know, you can swim.
Yeah.
I don't know what the timer is, I assume.
Oh, jeez. No, I feel like seeing some of this stuff, this game really needs, like, a spiritual successor.
Yeah, I know. I would love to see the follow-up to this.
Like, Dead Rising definitely borrows a bunch of the good ideas from this, but unfortunately
it's a long game.
Which I think kind of defeats the purpose.
Yeah.
Like, the hour time limit, I think.
Oh,
is
I think an hour is, like, a really good... Well, and there's that Breath of Fire that you really like, but that's also, like...
Oh,
like,
it's
10 hours or so?
Yeah, and it's not really a Majora's Mask type thing. It's a weird thing where, like, the cutscenes get longer if you die and choose, like, one of two ways of restarting your game.
Mm-hmm.
It is the strangest thing. And that game, just for chat, that's Breath of Fire Dragon Quarter, which is Breath of Fire with a bunch of original Resident Evil stuff influencing its design. Indie game around the time of Fez came out that was very similar to this. I don't know of one, but I'd definitely be curious.
If there is, I'd love to play it.
No, this feels like some really good, interesting, largely unexplored game space.
I like this. Well, I don't think, I think our sister is not,
Alright. I think she's dead.
She's, yeah. Because her part of the ship is, I'm pointing at the part that's underwater. Yeah, there is a PS2 sequel to this that does not play like it in any way. It has none of the mechanics whatsoever. Which seems like, you know, a real missed opportunity. It's just basically the name and also the idea of a ship. Okay, so let's just keep climbing up. If we survive, I think that
yeah, we'll
be
call that a win for this round. See, again, the idea is that we're gonna revisit each of these games over the next few weeks.
How do I climb
since all of them
these
are
stairs.
Sort of either episodic or made to be replayed.
Yep.
Can you get?
Oh! Welp. Not gonna have much time left. I really
hope
we're not underwater.
Oh,
that was it. Cool.
So that was SOS.
That was SOS.
Okay, so you want to get the,
All right. Now, be a Zelda.
Yeah, let me see if Twitch actually knows that exists. Legend of Zelda. Oh, we may actually have a Zelda game it doesn't know. Please choose a supported game. Is there another?
I would just call it Legend of Zelda.
It's not auto-completing. How do you pronounce the weird system it was on, the Satellaview?
S-A-T-T-L. Yeah, just say Legend of Zelda.
Okay. Is it like that? Please choose a supported game. Okay, something weird's going on.
The Legend of Zelda? Does it require...
Okay, it's auto-completing now. Let me try that again.
Okay, so the emulator we're using is Hegan, which is incredibly accurate Super Nintendo emulation. It's extremely slow and requires an incredibly powerful computer to run a lot of stuff at any like decent frame rate. But it's also necessary for the stuff that we're emulating.
Is
not
this...
SOS. For that, you can use anything, but for the Satellaview
stuff. Is this BS Zelda no...
Oh, yeah. Zelda no Densetsu?
Yeah,
that's... Yeah, that's
cool. Okay.
Legend of Zelda in Japanese.
Updated. I'll be back in a sec. Navigate all the wires.
I've played Hydrophobia. It's cool, but it doesn't actually do anything particularly interesting with the water physics. Not nearly to a degree that you'd hope. It's mostly just like flavoring. Anyway, so we're gonna be showing. Actually, I'll wait for Miguel to get back because this is fairly weird. Oh yeah, the WonderSwan is it's a really interesting handheld that Bandai made. It was actually made by Gunpei Yokoi, who is the person who did a lot of worked at Nintendo for a long time. He developed the Game Boy. He left Nintendo after developing the Virtual Boy, that panned. He left, and then he went to Bandai to make the WonderSwan, which unfortunately didn't have that many games. But it had an interesting thing where it had two D-pads and you could change the alignment based on what game it was, so you could actually have games for it that were like in a portrait orientation. Oh, okay, a different town with no name. Sorry, just one second. Yes, beer is important.
Yep.
Okay, so I decided to hold off on explaining the
Teleview?
Yeah. Here, take controller.
Okay.
I delete the same file. So the Satellaview is a piece of hardware for the Super Famicom that was, it would connect to a satellite radio station and could download games as well as play games that were designed for it. Part of the thing was that it would only broadcast during certain hours, so basically you had to leave it on, have it download at certain times, and then you could save it onto the RAM cartridge, and then you could replay them later for some games. Some were just like regular old downloadable content. Others were games that were broken up into chunks, so you could play for an hour at a time because it was part of a live broadcast. So, Legend of Zelda is one of those games that basically they had a weekly broadcast. You would tune in at a very at on the hour. Right now we're getting no signal detected because there's obviously no satellite radio.
They're not in Japan and in the past.
And this is the system menu for it. It's this very cute little town. The emulation is, we're doing something wrong because there's supposed to be stuff in the town. So right now you can wander around. I think there's some stuff that you can buy, like there's an inventory with like some weird RPG
like this
framing.
Onion fountain. Quality onion fountain.
But yeah, so Legend of Zelda was it was over the course of 4 weeks, you would play an hour of Zelda every week, and because it was satellite radio, it actually had live audio incorporated into it, which would just be what you heard if you were listening to the radio station at that time. Okay, I'm gonna fire up the phone now.
I just want to point out that the perspective on this character is deeply, deeply wrong, and
it's
very upset by it.
It's deeply wrong in a lot of ways.
As a pixel artist, I am angry.
Yeah, no, they're going for a cute Earthbound type thing, but it's not quite...
Yeah.
It's not quite as good as... Okay, so I'm going to load up...
Okay. The actual game.
So, this has been emulated in certain amounts over the course of... a while. Part of the problem with emulating this is, because there's a live component, like a live radio broadcast component to it, there's no way to get like a ROM dump of that. Just because, you know, it didn't get saved. It was just literally playing audio. So the only reason why we know is because people did actual, like, VHS recordings of their screen while they played, and we have enough of those that we were able to, like that people were able to construct what the script was, and, so what we're playing right now is a fan dub of the game. So this is, like, a bunch of people got the script, and they did their own recording, and using this one particular emulator that is able to play videos and audio over gameplay. We're actually able to sort of the closest thing possible to emulating this game. BS Zelda is the only one. There were actually a bunch of games that were in this format. There was an F-Zero. Oh, got narration.
This world was created by the gods. The gods, as proof of their great power, left behind an artifact of three golden triforce, the triforce. One ruled power, one governed wisdom, and one.
So right now we're looking at a video recording of what would it be, of what the loading screen would have been. Which is why it looks fairly low quality.
Cannot hear narration. Okay, I'm turning it up.
Okay. So yeah, if what's on screen looks low quality, that's why.
After finishing chapter 4, players...
Somewhere. Descended from heaven.
So what happened was that they ran this a bunch of times, so there were rerun events of this. Even after, like, Nintendo stopped officially supporting it, the radio station, like, they kept doing it anyway. Even though there's no new content.
These are the words passed down the land of Hyrule. Obtain the golden power of the Triforce.
Oops, shit. I didn't know that would do anything.
Okay, we just skipped the video, it's fine, there was nothing interesting
okay.
going on there anyway.
Can people hear okay now?
Here, let me take the
electricity. Yeah.
Yeah, we all know this story. So this is the original, despite being on the Super Nintendo, this is the original NES. Zelda, except, which is why it has really weird controls, I keep forgetting. And instead of playing as Link, you play as the character from the menu. It sounds like it's still a bit quiet.
No, I'm just saying we're talking over it occasionally. Still a bit quiet, okay.
So, yeah, so instead of playing as Link, you play as the character from the UI of, that we were showing of that little town. So this is the only Zelda game where you can play as a girl, so we're definitely going to do that. Oops. Oh no. This is, it's not a great cursor. Oh yeah, so the way this works is that it breaks up Legend of Zelda into like four chunks. There's certain parts of the map that are currently blocked off. You can only see some of it. And no matter how far you get during your playthrough, because you only had an hour, you couldn't replay it because like literally the broadcast wouldn't be there. Like people have ROM dumps of it, but it's not the actual, you wouldn't be able to play.
Welcome, hero. The people of this land have all been awaiting your arrival. Ah, do not be surprised. I knew that you would come to this land, guided by the stars. Now then, hero, gather the pieces of the Triforce that was snatched away, and bring down the evil King Ganon. I shall send power to you from here. One more very important thing. This world exists only within a predetermined time. When the moment comes, this world, like a dream, shall vanish. To begin, seek out the evil king's dungeon said to lie somewhere within this land. Hurry, hero. Take this sword.
Okay, now we have player control.
There are things that you must learn that will aid you on your quest. Press the A and Y buttons to use your sword. Please press them now. Next, I want you to press the X button.
This is me.
Is called the subscreen. Here you can manage the items that you possess. To choose a held item, press the X button to return to the game after making your selection and press B to use the item. To switch the item you want to use, press the X button again to call up the subscreen. There is also a way to switch items using L and R. I will pray for your good fortune.
So the map is different than the original Zelda, but also I don't know that very well anyway. I've only played it a tiny bit. So, this will be interesting.
Rude.
No, I'm not gonna do that.
According to the old man, the Triforce lies within the dungeons of the evil king. Rumor has it that the dungeons boast a variety of traps. This week, you will be searching for the level 1 and level 2 dungeons. You should soon be able to find the first dungeon. However, level 2 remains hidden somewhere.
Okay, yeah, so this is an example of
whether
right now we can't go left, so
dungeon,
that part of the map
the
is blocked
King's
off.
The underlings will target you. When your power to fight foes has been exhausted, the fairies will offer you their protection. The springs are where they dwell.
So yeah, in the top left you can see the world map, but you don't actually have app, and it's, I think, half the size of the regular Zelda one. Because, you know, you only have 4 hours in total to play this entire thing. But even then, it's like sectioned off.
What happens if you die?
I think you get revived. At least that's what I assume, because they talk about the fairy, the power of the fairies. Is that the dungeon? Yes! Wow! I found it! Nice!
Ooh, I like the pixel art on this.
Yeah. It's... like, it's still, like, definitely, like, in the style of, like, Zelda 1, but, you know.
With more color-ups?
Yeah. And, yeah, and all the dungeon layouts are different, too. And, like, they would actually change them per broadcast.
Where are you, hero? Where are you fighting now? There's no mistake that with your current power, you will face a difficult battle. For just a little while, your sword will be granted power. Do you understand? All those who hear my voice now, fight upon this land. If you do not set to fulfill your mission immediately, you will be failing to them.
What's this? Even though your life meters are full, you can still throw your sword. You may be able to recover the Triforce during this time. However, be conscious of the life you have remaining. Plunge in hastily, and you may be...
So this is a scripted event. This happens always at the 10-minute mark, precisely because it's a live broadcast. There's no talk button.
A currency known as rupees is necessary. Bombs? G's? It is best to be ever conscious of your amount of rupees. You will know by the number shown at the top of the screen.
Check the inventory, maybe?
So right now we don't actually have a...
Yeah.
We don't have a bow or anything.
As one might expect, the shield at the merchant cell is more powerful than the one you currently possess. It can defend against the balls with which the Zoras will emerge from the water and attack.
So the other thing is that the narration can't, like, react to what you're doing at all, precisely because it's just literally what is being played on the radio at this time. Which, you know, is kind of weird, actually.
So it can drive things in the gameplay that don't have to do with your location, like giving you the power
exactly.
to fly. But it can't,
And in some of them, like,
Oh, map.
So, like, for F-Zero, this actually doesn't matter because, you know, like...
Was it a super narrative F-Zero experience?
No, it was just like listening to the radio while driving. Which is... Oh, and yeah, so you can see that, the layout of this dungeon is the shape of an S, because, it's after, the radio station that this was on was called St. Vega, which incidentally was a really... Oh, right. I've played this album before. Did a really weird broadcast, like, they didn't really, like, have conventional programming or schedules. They just would, like, do really long mixes that just sort of, like, gradually transitioned to different genres. It was super weird, super experimental, and it absolutely did not make them any money, which is why they needed to rent out hours of their broadcast time to Nintendo in order to, like, stay on the air. They didn't last... Oh! I'm not good.
Do you have the,
Let's check. Yeah, still the bow.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, let's assign that to... How do I...
Do you need to move it over?
I'm trying to.
Oh, try the... It said trying the triggers when you're on the regular.
Is
you.
Oh.
Was also a way to do it.
Okay. Let's... Weird.
Oh.
Oh no, this is not, this isn't, this is just an objective screen.
Oh, okay.
This isn't actually a... Oh,
but
okay.
There's another one.
Yeah, if you press select, you get this, which is telling you what you should probably have by the time
the hour is finished.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I'm not sure how you actually equip the bow. Okay, this is a problem. I'm not really...
You can no longer throw your sword. The effect appears to have worn off. It seems you must now fight with more caution than ever.
Let's try going back. Yeah. That's just not bad. What's the chat saying?
Ah, yes, who doesn't remember the eight pugs of the Triforce, Octoforce? Oh, we can't use it until we have arrows.
Oh, okay.
I thought you just said the arrows cost money.
Yeah.
I guess you have to buy them, though? I assumed it just meant to use rubies.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Perhaps you have obtained a bomb somewhere. You can use the bomb with the B button. It is said that within this earth there are cliffs and walls that can be destroyed with bombs.
So I definitely have it.
In dungeons, particularly, are statues of faces embedded in the walls. It is said that some of these stone statues can be destroyed using bombs. It is also said that somewhere there are mysterious blocks that move.
There's a lot of the narration sort of play tips.
I wonder if that'll change over time.
Yeah, I know, I'm curious as we get into the later ones. Like, we've had a timed...
Oh, got bombs now.
We've had a timed situation that did something good for you. I wonder if they'll do the opposite.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
Where it's like, you have one health for the next little bit. Or, like, you can't use this powerful
item. Oh man, that'd be cool. Puzzles. Oh god, it's so hard when you don't have the laser.
You have to buy one arrow, then each arrow after that costs one rupee.
Okay, that's terrible. I hate that. I'm really glad they didn't do that in subsequent games. Oh no. Yeah, it's... I definitely do like how the laser sword really changes the way you approach things.
Yeah, like it would be great
to have
that right here.
Yeah, I mean, part of that is just, like, interesting design and, you know, how regular Zelda works.
How fares the battle?
Pretty poorly.
I am now pursuing some sealed forbidden manuscript. I shall try using the spell that is in the chapter of lightning, directing it against the evil king's minions. Aha!
Oh, that's fantastic. Cheesy, but fantastic.
I love it. So yeah, so the Zelda time clock is also... That's... how much time?
What was the clock you could have picked up? What would that do?
It freezes all enemies on screen.
Oh, okay.
I
so not super useful in an empty room.
No, not so much. And also, definitely, like, time is of the essence here, because we have to do two dungeons this run. And we're supposed to get all this.
Yeah.
That said, if we fuck it up, like, it'll still start, like, we can still play next week.
with just failures.
Yep. Yeah.
In Miyamoto's eyes.
Exactly.
All right, I can deal with the shame. Man, these blobs are so strange.
They
feel
aren't they supposed to be
small.
Like? They're too small. They're supposed to be like there's bigger ones. Or, I don't know if there are in this one, but I know in Link's Awakening there are bigger ones that split into those.
Yeah, no, it's weird to see them start out that size though.
Listen well, hero. A heart container has appeared before my eyes. There's no mistake. It is something newly washed ashore. I can hear the sound of the waves. You should obtain the heart container. I believe it'll help you with your fight.
What could the heart container that appeared to the old man be? A place where the waves can be. The heart container under the eastern pier has been there from the beginning. It looks like you can't obtain it at the moment. That must mean that there's another place for you to hear the sound of the waves.
Oh, neat.
Oh, man. Yeah, it's like, it's puzzles, exactly like,
So we need to find a certain part of the map
where
that item would be, and it would only show up at this point. That's really neat.
Shit. Just lost screen.
Oh.
Oh god. How do I fight this thing? Can I use shield?
Yes, it is a fan translation.
Oh, thank god. Oh, is that a boss?
Have you found any walls or cliffs yet? Put your bombs to good use.
Yeah, okay, it was a boss. Cool.
Consider the fact that there are caves of old men and merchants. There may be other secrets hidden all over Hyrule.
Okay. Cool, we did it. Now we
gotta find the other one.
Yeah, now we have to find level 2, and also, hopefully that heart container.
And maybe buy some arrows as well.
Also that, yeah.
It looks like we're also supposed to find a potion.
It's said that there's
an old
woman who lives in a hidden cave among the cliffs. Where could she be? Rumor has it that the old woman sells life-restoring medicine. That's something you want to get after delivering the letter. You should do so quickly.
Delivering the letter?
Oh, there it is.
That's the one that they said you couldn't get to yet.
Oh, okay. So there's another...
Yeah, there's another spot with waves. Also, it sounds like there's probably a spot where I need to bomb somewhere in the cliffs.
Yeah.
Around here.
I mean, they'll be visible, right?
I don't know.
Well, they usually mark.
We know that there are two Triforce pieces to find
this. Oh, shit, two?
However, only one dungeon.
Because two dungeons, right.
It appears the second entrance's location cannot be found without bombs.
Okay,
it seems like they poorly timed this knowing that we'd be in this area.
But this would happen even if we were still in the dungeon. They just...
Yeah, I know it would. But they also just gave us a thing to convince us to go towards this area.
Yeah, exactly.
Because they mentioned.
Let's use this time to review items used with me. Bombs are a very powerful weapon.
Amazing.
However, not only can you attack with them, they can also be used to break walls. This is important, so be sure to remember it. Let's try to break a stone wall.
Okay, I'm really not sure where to go. Ah, yeah, that's definitely looking like a fun time. No? Really? Okay.
Try shoving? These are shovable in this Zelda?
I don't think so. Yeah, doesn't look like it. Alright, that's a mystery. That might just be like the map blocking
yeah.
us off.
For this week.
So the other thing is that even the music is a live broadcast, so which is why this doesn't sound like something that would be necessarily possible on Super Nintendo.
Can't get over there.
No, that's not possible.
Boomerang can be used to stop enemies in their tracks. It is also
oh, right,
useful
there's a shop
for
here,
targets
that
are out of your reach. Furthermore, you can throw it diagonally.
Oh my god, that's expensive.
We're not getting the shield today.
Nope.
So somewhere in the cliffs is supposed to be an old lady to be
yeah.
a big bomb.
Okay, so
the cliffs.
Yeah.
So I guess bombs cost rupees.
Oh, there
well.
We go. Yeah, now we can.
Yeah.
Now we can.
A bow is required to use arrows.
One oh, bow and arrow is a separate thing. So it's you get the arrow
merchants
item,
sell
then you
arrows.
Get the bow item.
However,
and then
whenever you fire your bow, your rupee count will decrease.
That's
so pay attention.
Deeply silly. I like it. It's deeply silly.
I think there's also some area for us to explore up past
yeah.
here, which might be where that heart container is.
What's the apple suggesting?
Oh, people are just talking about how difficult it was to put all of this together.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, so, yeah, we can't go further than this.
Okay.
That said, that looks really suspicious.
You could try
if
here.
I, yeah, if I was putting a bomb, all the things on the right there.
Yeah.
Oh, wasn't, well, I'll take it.
Wasn't the old lady, but it looks like we found the other dungeon.
Yeah, we found the dungeon, so that's even better.
I'm digging this mix.
Yeah, yeah.
This must have been amazing to play
I know.
At the time.
Like, that would have... Wait, did we just get the boomerang out of the...
Yeah.
Wow. Cool. Cool. That's very strange, but I'll take it.
Compass.
Wait, it can't grab items. Alright. Can't deal with
this. I know the sense
boomerang.
Of, like, the whole community, like, playing this game at the same time.
Yeah, exactly. Like, everyone would be playing at the same time. And you'd be like, oh, what do you think the pro strat for next week will be? And also, like, so, like, now the dungeon layouts are known, but you only realize that they spell something out, like, at the end. So, like, they rebroadcast this different times with different maps, so, like, I think, honestly, like, it would be pretty interesting each time. Because, you know, you'd still have to be... You'd know, like, what items you're looking for, but you know that anyway now, because this is Zelda. You've played Zelda. Probably. Well, I haven't, but...
It makes me think of the hacks they have of A Link to the Past, where it remixes the order you get things in.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, so the shape of this one is T, and all the dungeons spell out Saint Giga. I can't use the sword in the doorway. That's a strange buck.
So we're reaching the halfway point.
Yeah, we're halfway through the
This seems like there must be something to bomb.
That's
or shove.
Seems, yeah.
I would guess north.
Well, north is the only direction of the room, so.
Oh, I was looking at the wrong spot.
Ah, yeah. Where's
I was looking at the red
for the green dot.
Yeah. Randomize Zelda. So the randomizer for A Link to the Past basically does a check to make sure that you can actually.
What's the matter, you say? The fairy living in the spring has disappeared? This, too, may be an act of the evil king. We cannot leave things like this. We must find the whereabouts of the fairies.
Oh, crazy.
The fairy in the spring has vanished. It seems the power of the evil king is having an effect. Without the fairies, the battle will become difficult. You've got to be careful.
Oh, I wonder if that means there are no fairies, like, as drops either.
Yeah, can you not restart now? Is that what that means?
Probably not. I think it means, like, fairies as items, not... Yeah. That would be a really shitty thing to do. Game over.
Yeah, I was saying, the randomizers have checks to make sure that you, you can actually still complete the game.
Oh, right. I've played Zelda before.
Even defeating an enemy won't cause a fairy.
Oh, yeah.
It's dangerous like this. You want some life-restoring medicine.
Which unfortunately we get from the, old woman who we haven't found yet. I just have the letter from her.
How do I fight this thing? Oh. Okay.
Head on, is that the deal?
It's, so it's the dong, it's Dodongo, so you have to give it bombs. But you just place them in front of it, and it
hits okay.
Them. Except there's no way I should know that unless I, played Zelda, but...
I think that's kind of...
Well, there's the old man who tells you, Dodongo dislikes smoke.
Yeah, somebody in chat just said, I hear Dodongo hates smoke.
Really? Where'd you hear that from?
I would have thought that was where. Did you check up above? I just looked in chat.
Let's circle around. Okay, so we've got all our primary objectives.
I shall try using the spell located in the chapter of fate.
Try a bomb, though, just to see if this.
Yeah, good point. Oh, well.
That wasn't very helpful.
I think that was a random event that we just happened to be there at the right time for, I think. Oh, well, that's not... That's not really what I wanted, but I'll...
Sure.
Alright, I'll take it.
Oh, wait, you can get that hug container with the
Right, of course. I've played a Zelda before. Oh, Okay, so it doesn't hurt these.
Yeah, it just stuns them.
Well, I know in this one. No.
Oh.
Oh, we can't. Darn.
Different Zelda rules.
Okay, so. Old woman is around the cliffs.
To try above there?
Yeah.
Are they always in the center? In
I don't
this generation?
Know. It seems like they tend to be in the center. Like, I don't know if that's like a hard and fast rule though.
Yeah.
Oh, and yeah, I can switch items with the triggers.
Oh. There you go.
Somehow, I've managed to find the whereabouts of the fairies.
The item we got on level 2 is the boomerang.
Now we can borrow their powers. Fortunately, they are friendly to you.
Boomerang doesn't count? Is there another item in level 2?
They also taught me a new spell. I shall try using this spell on you.
Are we getting a fairy from? Yeah.
The fairies have become your friends. Now you hold the advantage of the fight.
Yeah, we're getting fairies as every item drop.
Awesome.
Every dungeon has an item in an underground room. Okay, so apparently we missed an item in that dungeon.
Okay.
By the cliff was surrounded by the flower monsters that fly in the sky, she has been forced into hiding against her will. It's probably a good idea to search for her using bombs.
Okay, so. The other screen, the one with the way too many flowers. Okay, so let's go here. Get the.
Okay.
This is incredible. I love this.
I'm curious if it was in English in the Japanese version, or
I think
it's
probably.
The...
I think it probably would have been in English. So there's one more room left.
I have now found a fearsome spell in the forbidden tomb. But it will help you in the fight.
Thanks, buddy.
Sure.
Good chat. Yeah, take fucking that.
Oh, I almost have enough of that good shield.
Yeah. Oh, this is the...
That just takes us to the
yep.
other part of the game. So I think we've done everything in this?
Yeah, looks like. Oh, yeah, we have all the items.
Okay.
Yeah, no, so it was a boomerang.
Okay. Did we find the old lady while I wasn't looking?
No, but we know where she is. She was surrounded by flowers. They said the flower monsters chased her off.
Okay.
So we have to go...
Find the flowers.
I saw that screen. It's, Yeah, come on. Let's get a top. Oh, okay, go. Good. Awesome. Do you want to take a little for a bit?
Sure. How do I exit out of this?
X.
track.
I know. If you kill one now, you'll get a fairy. Yeah, which gives you the laser sword, which is really necessary. Although you can also hit bats with the boomerang. He'll kill them. Okay, so it's, I think the screen's to the left. Yeah, you're gonna wanna get a fairy first.
Oh. The fairies have returned to their springs. It seems as though they have fled from the evil king's power. The springs have now regained their previous power. The fairies who aided you will not lend you their power anymore.
We done goofed.
Take care as you keep fighting.
Yeah, so this screen has to be up.
Yeah.
So you have to kill them all. I think you could probably use I bet you could use the bow for this.
Yeah.
I haven't been using it at all.
This week, the goal was to recover two Triforce pieces.
So,
you already have them. It's best to collect rupees and buy items in preparation for next week.
Oh. Yeah, so they carry over each week. Oh, and you can't hit them when they're in the air.
Oh.
If you use the boomerang, you can grab that fairy.
Why don't you try one thing? Have we tried bombing this area?
No, we haven't.
Okay.
But yeah, it's they said you need to get rid of the box.
Okay.
We're probably overheating.
Okay, yeah.
Sorry, you might get some noise, but our computer's running really hot.
Okay, so we've killed all of the...
What about the Zora?
Yeah, I'll try. Gotta try bombing in other areas. There we go.
Okay. don't what are you doing? It's an item. Equipment.
Yeah.
You just press that. Yeah.
Oh my god.
There is one final greater spell written in the lightning chapter. I shall use it right now.
Okay, cool. So we got everything. We
awesome.
Now we're just now we're just gonna go around and
farm rupees.
Yeah,
and
farm some
maybe
rupees.
Buy that. Not the most useful time to freeze a bunch of enemies.
Yep, not that good.
So the other thing we've learned is that there might be stuff hidden at any point. It's not just in the center.
Yeah.
So it might be worth... I've played basically
Generation
of Zelda.
Same. I've I played a little bit of Zelda 2, but not any of, basically none of this one. Like, this is already way more than I played of, this one. So one thing is that the shield is automatically used if you're not swinging your sword.
Yeah. Now that's in later ones.
Oh really? It's on the Game Boy ones. In the Game Boy ones, the shield is a distinct item. You have to hold down the button for it. Which means that, like, you know, you can make loadouts, and one loadout is sword
yeah.
shield.
Yeah, I think it's a distinct item, but I don't know if you have to hold a button for it in Minish Cap. I can't remember.
A fearsome vision has appeared to my eyes now. A figure that strides on, enveloped in smoke, destroying monsters, rocks, and walls. This is not my own power. The power of the stars that guide you through this world emerges through me. Perhaps I can transfer it to you.
You have like a more powerful bomb or something now.
Tracing on those rocks that were blocking out that dungeon.
Yeah.
Has been a change in your items.
Oh, you have infinite bombs
something
now.
About the Emperor's bombs. It
Look.
Seems you'll be able to use them to your heart's content.
Okay.
Yeah, see the bomb counter is infinite.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. So that's interesting. It seems like they give you a superpower at the end. Yeah, no, so you can catch up. Christine is saying that yeah, it's to catch up. People cannot hear her in the other room. Bomb the hell out of this place. Found something. What? Huh. Oh shit, we've got enough for the shield. I do not understand how that game worked. I'm not sure, there might be limes in the fridge. Found the dungeon in the one lock, yes.
come bearing gin and also tonic.
Excellent.
But no lime.
I am basically running around and hitting myself with bombs. I found a clue that told you where to, like, find one of the dungeons.
Ah. Yeah, I guess you don't if you're really scrambling.
I think we may have found... Oh, wait. I think I can... Is the shop here? I think this is
yes.
the shop.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Against the shield.
Yeah. So we got it for next week.
Yeah.
It's a better looking shield.
Yeah.
So I have a feeling we've basically cleared everything.
I think so, yeah. Now we're just collecting.
You know, it's interesting how the events are set up to basically balance the fact that people would have different skills.
Oh, I see. It now deflects the Zorans.
Oh, it deflects it back as opposed
yeah.
to just...
Or no, but it doesn't do damage. It
that you cannot
more.
Reach no matter how hard you try. The time will surely come when you can reach them. You should keep them in mind.
But yeah, now we're just basically farming for next time. Gotta get those arrows.
I am garbage at this game. I've never found the combat to be particularly good in a lot of the early 2D Zeldas.
I definitely don't think that's
even Link to the Past is not that great combat-wise.
Oh yeah, no, for sure.
Minish Cap is pretty good.
Yeah, well, like the Game Boy one's all, you know, because it's all about like combinations. I think that's a little more interesting. And also you're a little more maneuverable in those. Whereas in this, it's very...
Yeah.
You have to...
Weird
like,
grid.
Yeah. You have to be directly in front of...
has disappeared. The power of the stars is also weakening. You must hurry. My power will not last long. This world will soon disappear. You have but a little time remaining to you. Take back the two Triforce pieces from the evil king's hands.
And they've done that.
It's one secret per screen. And remember, you don't have infinite
bombs
now. Oh, yeah.
Time is running out. Is there anything left undone? Do you have the bow? Did you get the boomerang?
Ah, wow. Good call. Oh, because we're near the... Oh, no. It's just...
Only a little time remains. Did you go? select both Triforce pieces?
Yes, we're good.
Victory lap.
Think like you should you have extra time to just grind for rupees is necessarily that bad a design decision, like, because having lots of rupees just means that you know, like, it means you can play a lot more freely.
And like, I definitely feel like they tried to design this so everyone would actually have won by the end of it.
Yeah, exactly. Like, well, like, we did this blindly knowing a little bit about Zelda 1, but frankly probably a lot less than players would have for this.
This world will soon disappear. Hurry, hurry.
So I'm not sure what the emulator will do when we get to the end of the broadcast, because it's all combined together in this ROM. That's the way the ROM hack works. But
can you take a do an image?
I think probably what's gonna happen is we're gonna get it's probably gonna like show another video and then we'll pause and do a save state.
Heated the hell out of those words. This reminds me of you to feel a letter.
To the very end, hero. I witnessed your bravery from here. Today's fight is finished, but that does not mean your mission is over. When this world appears again, perhaps you arrive at my door once more. Next week, you shall take care of anything you believe you may have left unaccomplished. These memories will not vanish. For as long as your fight continues, until next time.
So it's not actually an hour long, it's actually 50 minutes long. The download starts on the hour, it takes 7 minutes to download the broadcast, and then starts at the 7 minute mark. I'm gonna get a save state here. I think probably that'll...
You got a save state?
I got a save state.
So we'll just see what it does from here on that.
Yeah.
Hells yeah.
I'm feeling pretty good about our chance of prevailing. Ah, okay. So this is the screen that we want. Start. Oh, select, then, yeah.
Then start.
Yeah, it's style controls. Cool.
That is super cool. Yeah, no, that was really interesting.
So the reason why the timer counts up instead of down is because it's real time. Like, you are actually, it started on the hour, so you're actually, like, looking at a real clock of 7 minutes past the hour until, you know, 57 minutes past the hour. And then there's the 3 minute ending.
Yeah, no, that, like, it's interesting because it has the episodic thing that feels really modern, and it has kind of the networked experience thing.
Yeah, I mean, what also, like, it does, like, have, like, I don't know to what extent it does score tracking, but, like, there is, like, some of that. And, like, I know for some of the live broadcasts, they did do, like, send in your high score, and we'll include it in, like, you could get that in, like, it would, like, stuff would show up in the town with no name.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Huh.
So, like, it is community sort of thing.
Possible similar themed game suggestion, Lifeline. Is that the one you
picked
up?
I just picked that up. We're going to try out, find out, if we can get a microphone working. It should be fun. I think it'll...
Yeah, no, I've got a semi-busted PS2 headset we can test out.
Yeah, so possibly we might do that after we finish with these. So for next week, we're gonna try SOS again now that we know a little bit more and hopefully pay a little more attention to the map.
We'll see what the next gross things our Seaman does.
God. And we'll tackle some more dungeons in Zelda.
Yeah. There's one thing with the high score thing. The only other action RPG I know that has a high score mechanic is actually the Oasis, Beyond Oasis game.
Oh, really?
That I really like. It has a whole thing. Basically, you can level up in it endlessly, but if you don't level up, you get a better score at the end.
Oh, that's really cool. I really like that.
Yeah. No, it's... I wish Streets of Rage people made more RPGs.
We're going to stream that at some point, right?
Yeah. We're definitely going to stream it.
Cool.
Because it's super interesting and super ignored. The PS2 did have a USB port. Yep, it definitely did. I think a regular one might work. I'm not sure if I have one.
I have like a
five. Well, other than the one that we use here already, which we wouldn't be able to use.
I have so many USB headsets because I keep reading them in places.
Yeah.
Buy new ones.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah. I'm sure one of them will work. They'll be good.
So yeah, barring any disasters, we'll be back next Sunday to do more of this ridiculous real-time game stream.
Please look forward to it.
Thanks a lot, folks.
Thank you.
How do I make stop?